then that animal has hair on its skin, and whose ears are seen give to birth to young ones. Yes, in that last session we have to learn animals have hair on skin, and whose ears are seen give to birth to young ones. That animals giving to birth to young ones. What that? Hairs on hair skin. Which animals? Lion, giraffe, monkey, polar bear. And ears big, buffalo, cow, elephant. These type of animals have big ears. We have to see that these type of animals giving to birth to young ones. That. Look at the board. Animals give birth to young ones and legs. Yes. Animals that give birth to young ones are called viviparous or mammals. Viviparous or mammals. Yes. That example lion, rabbit, rat, deer, etc. Teeth, etc. That animals with no head and whose ears are not visible by legs. That legs animals are called oviparous animals. Yes. Which animals have on their skin hair and which animals have ear bits? We can see the ears that animals give to birth to young ones. Birth to young ones. They are called mammals. Viviparous. See, animals that give birth to young ones are called viviparous or mammals. They are example lion, rabbit, peacock, lion, rabbit, rat, deer. These are called. Which next one is that here identify the difference between these animals with no head and whose ears are not visible. Whose ears are not visible. Like hen, snakes, lizards. This type of animals are so there now. We have to learn before the lesson. Yes or no? That animals with no hair and whose ears are not visible by legs. Animals. That legs are called oviparous animals. What is that? Oviparous animals. Example, birds, fish, frogs, tortoise, crocodiles, etc. Yes. These animals we have to count, identify the ears on their body. Then that animals are called oviparous animals. That animals given to birth to young ones by laying eggs. By laying eggs. See, look at the last one. These animals, which animals? Oviparous animals. Young ones develop inside eggs. Inside eggs. The young ones hatches out of the egg after its development is complete. Its development is? Tell me. Its development is complete. Its development is complete. Then the egg after coming young ones. Example, hen, fish, lizard, crab. See, these animals, which animals? Oviparous animals. Young ones develop inside eggs. The young ones hatches out of the egg after its development is complete. Hatches. Hatches and daily potagadam. Polani, eggs petti nanta, oka chota 21 days, oka danto petti, according to skeleton, pina kucha petta. Swarm up the hatches. That is called hatches. Hatches out of the egg. After it is development, is complete, the young ones will come out. So, example, hen, fish, lizard, frog, etc. Understand? Up to here, we have to learn about the different types of animals. First one is that viviparous animals are mammals that give to birth to young ones. And legs are called, animals are called mammals. They have to give to birth to young ones. They have to feed. feed the animals, given to milk the milk to the young ones. They have to feed their own milk. Feed their own milk. Example, cow used to milk to their young one, and buffalo, and monkey, and human beings also, lion also, deer also. Understand? Okay, now children. Now with this complete. Now next one, animals with no hair on and whose ears are not visible, we can't see. That legs are called oviparous animals. That is birds, fish, frogs, reptiles, and crocodiles, etc. These animals, which animals? Oviparous animals, young ones develop inside the eggs, and the young ones hatches out of the egg after its development is complete. Example, hen, fish, lizard, frog. These animals hatches the eggs after its development is complete, after the baby young one will